And I have a little story for you. It's a little bit embarrassing, but I was doing a class at a community centre, a new one, on Monday. And the lady who rung me up wasn't actually there, and she rung me about 6 months ago. And then she rung back and I said, I want £30 to do the class. You know, and she said, well, normally what we do is, you know, you hire the hall, people pay you. And I said, yeah, but, you know, if you want me to do it, because I thought I had turning up there for three, and second week as three people, got to pay £15 for the class and they're giving me £3. So she said, I'll have a word with the committee, and she come back 6 months later and she said, okay, that's okay. When can you come? And I said, whenever you're ready. And she said, well, can you come next Monday? So I said, yeah. And then during the conversation, she kept mentioning Humumbe. So 11 o'clock I'm supposed to be there, so I get there at 10:45, outside Humumbe Hall. It's open, but the doors are locked. She said, a lady will come and open. I'm sat in my car, you know. Lady pulls up in a car and gets out, goes and sort of does something with the numbers on the door. Says, excuse me, leave it open. I'm coming in, I'm doing the Tai Chi class. And she said, oh, I thought it was art this morning. So I said, well, it's a new class, you know, probably haven't been told. So I goes down to this room, opens the doors, and there's all tables and chairs set out. So I thought, went to the next room, an empty hall, about a third of the size of the, that'll do for me, I thought. So I put my bag down, I'm early, I do a bit of Tai Chi. So I did my Tai Chi two or three times, left my phone in the car. Don't want your phone, do you? When you're training, you know, bleeping off, disturbing your class. Do a bit of Tai Chi dance, did Tai Chi dance for a bit. Nobody's turning up, you say, you know. So I went back, couldn't find anybody in the building. You know, so I went back, reception, 11:20. I might as well go, nobody's turning up. Goes, gets back in my car, picks up my phone, couple of messages. Just going to look at them, the phone rings, it's Giselle. Had a lady on the phone, very annoyed. They're waiting for you at Osgoode Hall. I said, I'm sure, she said, Humumbe. Well, Osgoode Hall. So, right. So I'm going round there. On the way round, I'm thinking to myself, I'll probably get round there. She's obviously a bit of a dragon, this woman. And she'll probably say, you know, this is no good, Mr. Gibbon. Do you know what I mean? Blah, blah. And I'll go, don't talk to me like I'm a schoolboy. You know, do you know what I mean? And all like this. When I get there, there's three ladies stood outside the community hall with a guy. And they don't look very happy. So without thinking, I got out the car. And, like, you know, you try to relax people, don't you, that to do Tai Chi properly. You can't do Tai Chi if you're annoyed with somebody, can you? So I opened the door and jumped up and I said, hey, you wouldn't be looking for a Tai Chi teacher by any chance, would you? And so that I brought a little weak smile. So I went in and I told them the story. And I was supposed to be there at 11:45. I looked at the clock, it was 11:45. And I could see they were all ready to, you know, tell me off. So I said, well, we've got 3/4 of an hour. I said, tell you what, my fault, we're late, won't charge you. Free lesson, let's go. Do you know what I mean? And I jollied them along. And I thought, I only did that because I've been teaching Tai Chi so long. You know, because, you know, there's no point in arguing with people, is there? You know, you might as well tell them the right. And then they can't argue with you anymore.